If they were sweating about spending $700 million in a cost of living crisis, you wouldn't know it today.
Well, it might be a stretch to say it's a beautiful day on Bribie Island today.
Premier Stephen Miles making his first election commitment of the 2024 campaign.
We have allocated $700 million to build this new bridge to Bribie Island.
A figure that comes from a business case that is yet to be finalised, Labor pushing ahead with their announcement without it. As for where the money will come from...
We've been very clear. Additional funding, $700 million from borrowings to deliver a duplicated bridge.
The state government arguing two bridges are better than one big one and will allow for traffic switching in emergencies.
This design is a value for money solution in a tight economic climate.
Both sides of politics now committed to the project.
It has always been the LNP's priority. It just is not the Labor Party's priority.
Both parties were today non-committal about when the bridge would be built. The LNP says it's working on a plan. Labor says it will be a top priority for a re-elected government.
If the LNP doesn't want to support it, that's fine.
Release the business case, release all the details, and then once we've had a look at that, we'll determine the position going forward.
They might need to build the bridge to get over the disagreement.
And Rosanna Kingson joins us in the studio now. And Rosie, the campaign pace and the bickering, it has certainly picked up.
Sharon, it was clear from the back and forth today, both sides of politics arguing who was more committed to a new Bribie Island bridge. For the LNP's promise to be taken seriously by voters, they will need to put their money where their mouth is, explain their plan and how they will pay for it. Stephen Miles is confident Labor can get construction underway in the next term of government, and the local member says the bridge would absolutely be complete by 2031, but Labor's election costings reveal construction will likely happen in the 2027-28 financial year, not long before the election after this one. Sharon and Max, first we'll need to see that business case.
All right, Rosie, thank you.